With the unique and vast terrain of Jammu and Kashmir, it is no surprise that prehistoric settlements have been found here. The largest evidence of early human activity in Kashmir is seen at the archaeological site of Burza Home, which is located 16 kilometers northeast of Srinagar. It was first discovered in 1935 and since then has shed light on a Neolithic culture that once existed in the Kashmir Valley. The Archaeological Survey of India has stated that similar Neolithic sites have been excavated in the region, but little to no information is currently available on these sites. The nearest Harappan site is found at Manda, which is located 143 km south of Burza Home and is considered the northernmost limit of the Indus Valley civilization, which we will later discuss in this video. It is known that the Harappans and Neolithic Kashmiris were contemporary to each other and had regular trade relations. It is also believed that Neolithic Kashmiris had commercial contacts with the people of the Tibetan Plateau based on similar tool characteristics. The phases of occupation at Burza Home are divided into four distinct periods, from the first two Neolithic periods to Megalithic to early historical period. Carbon dating has shown that the first period of the Burza Home cultural complex started before 2357 BCE. The culture at Burza Home was primarily hunter-gatherer, which, unsurprisingly, was also characterized by beads, bangles, and ceramic wares. People lived in pit dwellings which were dug by long stone celts. It has also been noted that some of these subterranean pits were also used as storage units. Walls of these pit dwellings were usually circular or oval, with the interior being narrow at the top and wide at the base. Mud was plastered on the walls of the pit and each roof was made from birch trees. These findings make it clear that the Neolithic builders of Burza Home had knowledge in protecting against the harsh weather. Ladders and steps have been found in some of the deeper pits which were put there to get to the bottom level. Crude pottery was handmade in different shapes and sizes, with the colors being steel grey, dull red and brown. The same type of crude pottery is still seen in Kashmir today. Tools were made of polished stone and animal bones, most of which were crafted from reindeer antlers. The tools were usually axes, chisels, arrowheads, spearheads, needles and daggers. These wide variety of tools were used for sewing, textile, hunting, crafting and fishing. Period 2 at Burza Home is believed to have started around 2000 BCE. Findings show that around this time people moved out of the pit dwellings and started to live in mud huts. Superstructures of wood were built on the ground level above the previously inhabited pits. Unlike the previous phase, pottery was now wheel-turned and consisted of smooth red ware. Pottery marks start to appear on some of these ceramic wares, which may be a characteristic borrowed from the Harappan civilization. A total of 950 beads were found in a red-wheeled turned pot with a painted long-horned wild goat. The painted figure on this pot looks eerily similar to the headdress of the Harappan Pashupati seal. Massive cultivation of dal, wheat and barley suddenly became more evident during this phase. The most well-known artifact from Burza Home is a stone slab dated to this time period. It depicts two scenes. One, showing a hunter shooting a stag, and the other showing a man waving towards the sun with a dog nearby. Burials at Burza Home were not seen until period 2. Analysis of the skeletal remains from these burials show that the people of Burza Home were of a Harappan type, but nonetheless a cultural complex of their own. Skeletal remains of stag and dogs were found buried alongside humans. Some skulls found here show that the locals had knowledge of trepanation, which is the surgical practice of drilling through the skull vault. Traditional craftsmanship of tools and pottery from the previous Neolithic phases continued to be in use. The dwelling places for the people of Burza Home were giant stone megaliths known as menhirs. With massive effort, the people of Burza Home dragged and set these giant stones to form what would become their homes. Many of these megalithic structures were found near the Neolithic era pits, suggesting a consistent transition between phases. Structures made of rubble were also found. The period 3 phase has also revealed metallurgy at Burza Home. This is mainly evidenced by several copper spearheads found at the site. The last known activity at Burza Home is around 3rd to 4th century CE, which is what is considered the fourth phase of occupation at Burza Home. The structures built here during this period were made of mud bricks, and the pottery was red ware pottery, mostly wheel turned as seen in the previous phases. Unlike the previous phases, this pottery included slip, which is a mixture used to plaster clay onto surfaces. It is unknown whether or not this population reflects the earlier Neolithic and Megalithic population that occupied the site. Burza home has remained preserved in its same form since excavation, and protection has since been issued to the exposed ruins. 143 kilometers south of Burza home is the Harappan site of Manda, which is settled on the right bank of the Chenab River in Jammu. The forests here are believed to have served as an advantage to the local population, as wood was cut and sent down river to nearby Harappan towns. This settlement is mainly dated to 2100 BCE, but around 15-25% of the pottery from the site is pre-Harappan. Most finds at Manda seem to be like any other typical Harappan sites. Pots, hearths engraved with Harappan script and an unfinished seal have been recovered, as well as jars, dishes, beakers, goblets and terracotta bangles. But what makes this site more interesting is that redware pottery, bone arrowheads and blades were also found, suggesting local affinities with Neolithic Burza home. Other than a collapsed wall-like structure, archaeologists could not make out any definite structures due to the restricted nature of the dig in the area. The settlement was abandoned around 1750 BCE, and the last known activity at this site was during the Kushan period. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. If you are interested in Harappan Hub, become a member by joining our Discord server. Link is down below in the description.